Fuck up. That's fuck up.
Nigga, you fuck up. Fuck
up. They tweaking.
I don't have no weed.
They tweaking. Damn, look at them arresting for no reason. You got no life.
You look like him. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Back. Do we have the?
All right. Usually like smoking already. Getting it together.
You know why you're not smoking already?
Why?
Cause you had to go to the bathroom again.
Prostate health.
Prostate, guys. Man.
Prostate health. Get your shit checked.
Telling you, all y'all. I don't know when is Prostate Awareness Month, but
man, we're gonna do a special episode.
Every Saturday.
Whenever Prostate Awareness Month rolls around.
Old niggas.
Gonna get us
getting their balls fondled.
Get us a urologist.
By doctors. Here. That's what they want, man.
That's disgusting.
Hey, man. Whatever it
they
takes.
They want a finger in my ass.
Whatever it takes.
Balls fondled. I'm good, bruh.
Damn, blood. What if it's a woman who doing?
Hey.
Yeah. Hey, right now, it's a
problem. Hey. But I don't want no finger in my ass regardless, my nigga.
Yeah, I just mean
my
like,
shit is exit only, brother.
I just meant the jiggling exit of the balls only. And things. Pause. Anyway, shout out to Chris Ill.
Once again.
Our DJ who still don't have our drops.
Still don't have our drops, you know. Still
his
don't
birthday
care
was
about
yesterday,
it.
Though, so he
okay,
so he
yeah,
in
happy
his bag.
Birthday Ill. And
happy birthday Ill.
He
wait,
in his bag.
Ain't we a year? This is a year that we've done this show.
This is a year
it's
anniversary.
Been a year.
This is a year anniversary.
Yeah.
Kinda. Kinda. Not to the date, but
not
like this
date,
week.
But...
This week ago last year we did this shit.
Yep.
Yeah.
For the people, man.
We kicked it off. For y'all.
We kicked it off. We risking our lives doing
every
this
day.
Shit. Every Saturday.
Every fucking Saturday.
Because smoking weed is illegal.
Do y'all
yeah,
appreciate
for you
it?
Clowns who think it's not. People still
you
they
put it
are
on the
still
line.
Beat fast when the police behind them, man.
Huh? You what?
People's hearts still beat too fast when the police
hell
behind
yeah.
them.
Hell yeah. Hey,
that
shout out
still illegal.
Shout out to the homie that got away. We showed that clip.
Yeah.
Shout out to him, man. But let me tell you, dickhead.
He said, I ain't got no weed on me. Need niggas to put the cameras down, man. Put your hands up and put them cameras down, man. If you're not fighting, walk away.
How about
everybody,
that?
You know, but everybody want to catch the, you know, the next fucking
the viral video.
The next viral video.
But
man.
Knockout videos happen so much. Who cares who filmed them?
But I'm just saying, what is the point of catching? The viral video, though.
Nothing. Not if you get a lot of followers. You can get a lot of followers if you're the first person to post the crazy video.
Yeah.
But after okay. that, if you don't monetize, what's the point? You better
I mean,
have
hey,
a plan.
Man. Hey, man.
But you know, we ask people, way too much.
Right. I was about to say, y'all going further into it than, you know, it really requires.
I just didn't know the world was America's funniest home videos. Everybody
no.
rushing to get the funniest well, video.
No, I'm not gonna say everybody. It's mostly us in America. Like, it's just us. We the only ones who really do this shit. I don't know if it's a world star in every part of the world.
But I don't know. But
do they still scream world star?
People still say world star.
World star!
Yeah, people who still wear denim jeans.
You useless paper money, motherfucker.
No, I would take it, but
like, what are you talking about?
When I say it's useless, it is whatever they motherfucking decide it is and shit. Like,
oh no, yeah, that's real.
You know what I'm saying? No, like, it's just
where is
Astra? Yeah, money. I mean, money, all of that shit though. Credit, that shit just an agreement. We don't have no Astra. That shit an agreement, man, between banks, bro.
Right.
It ain't real.
Nigga, one day, I got transferred $150.
Mm-hmm.
I transferred 50 of that instantly to somebody else. Mm-hmm. Went to the store, swiped my card for 35 of it or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? And then fucking paid a bill electronically with the rest of it. Never at any point did I see a check. Did I fucking touch any paper money?
No coins, no nothing. I mean,
you fucking up the game though, bro. I'm gonna keep it real with you. You need to start using cash.
I think cash.
You know, all my beauticians, barbers, all my hand-to-hand drug sellers, man. Like, man, Joe, we need cash to be in existence.
We don't need
niggas detailing every dollar that we that. You know
I try to
saying?
Give people like that cash, honestly. Like, I try to get my barber cash if I can. But then he started accepting everything. He's like, man, I got Venmo, I got cash.
And they putting that shit on your taxes now. That shit finna be on your taxes now.
My barber said something about that. I heard him say it to another
cut it out.
And I did. I just blanked it out. I didn't want to hear it. Talking about, yeah, you can just pay me through cash. I said, no.
Niggas getting
not
drugs.
Not my barber. My barber.
Yeah.
He 40. He ain't supposed to be doing that.
Yeah, my barber
like,
over 40.
You a G. Like, yeah, man, you gotta get it how you get it, man, you know?
You know, my barber's swaggy, though, and shit.
Yeah,
so
my barber.
You know, he trying to, he got art on the walls and shit.
My barber a real nigga, man, you know what I'm saying? He just, I always seen him get cash. It was crazy to hear him say it to someone else. I did not want him to say it to me. I would never disrespect him like that. I just won't come if I don't get it. Before I just be like, let me pay you a dub and you're gonna cash out.
I'd be fucking zelling the shit out of my barber.
Y'all niggas is foul, bro.
I do feel bad. I do feel bad when I zell them and shit.
Y'all need to stop that shit.
Yeah, seriously. I only don't do it like that because there's still places I go that don't accept cards. So it'd be like, I gotta stay loyal to cash.
This is all Amazon and all these other motherfuckers grand playing though, man. They're taking over the world, man.
Apple got a card coming this
Yeah, Apple got a card to just.
I saw that.
Apple's like, look, we're gonna eliminate all this shit.
That shit wicked though.
A card, it ain't got no numbers on it. It's just a chip and your name.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying,
that shit
man.
Fucking
you
don't wicked.
Want that? You wanna hit this?
I mean, I smoke your nasty ass blunt. It's skimpy as hell,
it's
too,
not skimpy,
boy.
Bro, you crazy. Mm-hmm. You like that,
this
don't
shit you? Trash.
Come on, bro. You smoke outdated blunts.
This shit trash. Amazon trying to take over the world. And Larry Rowe trash blunts. These are the facts that I just want to put out. Amazon giving niggas motherfucking $25 gift cards, nigga, for body scans, nigga. They want to scan your body.
Amazon about to create Westworld on y'all ass.
Exactly, nigga. This is what I'm trying to tell
you. When I saw that, I was like, you know what?
This is real?
$25 gift card, bro.
Wow.
Listen, look.
What?
So listen, to your Westworld thing, right? So listen, they got all your data, right? All your likes, all this shit you like. It's listed, nigga, on the computer, nigga. They got your whole fucking digital life. Mm-hmm. Bitches you like, the food you like, everything, nigga. Mm-hmm. You zelling it up.
Shit you talk about.
Now here they go, they do a body scan. We got another motherfucking money running around here, bro.
They can try.
You know what I'm saying?
They can try.
They gonna
do it. I'm trying to tell y'all, man, y'all niggas better wake up, bro.
I mean, so the thing, I do think that they are going to try some old Westworld shit, but I don't think they're going to try it on some, like, we're going to duplicate Terry and Monty and Larry and shit.
We're going to make new y'alls.
Oh, bad niggas.
I think
they
just
using.
I think
they
would just use your image to create a person because, I mean, you're so much more than fucking the clicks and shit online. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're not going to. Yes, yes. 100%.
Tell that to a motherfucker who drops off of Twitter because he getting too many in his ads. Niggas, that is what niggas are. They are they fucking computer identities today, bro. Nobody is their real self. What are you talking about? Y'all sound crazy. Y'all don't know this? Nobody's their real self.
What I know is that I'm not fucking with that Amazon shit. They not finna scam me, bro.
I'm not getting scammed.
They got
the idea of a real self. We can get into some real existential shit. You know what I'm saying? Some, you know,
I know,
real
right?
Self. That, like, that's just crazy. But no, but for real, like Amazon's gonna fucking
they taking over,
Jeff Bezos
bro.
Is gonna create Westworld, and everybody who got their body scanned is gonna be some character in fucking Westworld and shit. You're gonna be getting fucking stabbed in the fucking head for fun because. You know, like, people want to live
saying,
out their murder fantasy.
Nigga, Amazon got niggas out here running around in regular clothes, nigga. Dropping shit off. Nigga, they ain't even
nigga.
Giving niggas uniforms.
Nigga,
they
I was Target.
A whole bunch of shit. They
I'm Target at the crib, Joe. Jobs. I swear to God, this shit threw me off. I'm parking at the crib. It's about 7, 8 o'clock at night. You know what I'm saying? The sun's kind of going down. It's this motherfucking minivan across the street. Motherfucking doors fly open. Motherfucking... Mexican lady, two Mexican dudes hop out.
You like, oh,
I'm like,
shit.
Oh, shit, what the fuck is about to go on? They just go in the back, grab hella packages, and they literally slinging them bitches on people's steps like fucking paperboy and shit, like walking up and down the street. I'm like,
that's
this is what Amazon.
That's somebody. It was an Amazon truck?
No, it was a fucking minivan.
No, just a minivan. Yeah, it's a minivan.
So
unmarked cars.
Fucking Dodge Caravan.
They doing it bad. Bad.
The nigga Ice-T say right. He almost shot a motherfucker, nigga.
He man. Almost shot an Amazon person. He thought they was playing with his mail.
That nigga say, yo, you niggas better motherfucker.
Now that you got regular, maybe your own, maybe you should wear a vest. Last night, they delivering at night too.
That's what I'm saying. You get your prime
like,
and shit.
They delivered to like 8, 9 o'clock at night.
No.
It's so, yeah, dark as hell.
This motherfucker had on jorts and a fucking t-shirt.
Exactly.
You know, throwing packages up on the porch and shit. I'm like, man, I'm not ordering. I don't really order shit from Amazon. You know what I'm saying?
I don't do too much Amazon.
I kind of curb that type of shit, you know?
Yeah, man. Is stay woke the appropriate thing for this?
I said?
Yeah,
you gotta stay woke, man.
Yeah.
That's definitely stay woke.
Don't
stuff.
Use Amazon, bro.
You see they tried to ban Facebook last night?
Who tried to ban
Facebook? It was like a
Facebook?
Whole hashtag, ban Facebook, ban Instagram. I don't know what it was about. It was on Twitter. Yeah.
It's some black people.
No, it wasn't black. It was the USA.
Yes, get it out of here.
They was on some,
Let's bring niggas back down to reality, Joe. Let's get it out. Let's get it out of here, Joe. Let's get rid of Facebook. Let's get rid of fucking Instagram.
It's only gonna go the other direction, man.
Where?
Motherfuckers gonna have their own walking avatars walking around pretty soon, like that movie. What was that movie? Bruce Willis.
Which
fucking one? Motherfuckers had like Android fucking copies of themselves walking around the world and shit. They stayed in the house, plugged up to a machine. That's where it's headed. It's gonna be crazy.
I don't know what the fuck you thought about.
Oh man, I had to look it up. It was fucking incredible.
The Sixth Sense, hell yeah.
They said right, Die Hard, exactly. Speaking of Die Hard, I saw John Wick 3 last night.
Oh, don't even tell
me.
I heard what you said.
John Wick is officially the baddest motherfucker on the planet, but I'm not even, you know.
Yeah, don't even. I've been like
that motherfucker is crazy.
Wick,
that motherfucker is John Wick, Joe. He's crazy. But anyway,
Wick, Joe.
Speaking of somebody who's wicked.
I don't know if he's wicked. He's a wild boy.
He's a wild guy.
I don't even want to go in on my man.
See, I don't really know the facts.
I don't know the facts, man.
I don't know the facts, but these facts we do know.
Okay, whatever.
The nigga got fired from everywhere.
Jason Mitchell is we talking about.
Eazy-E.
Unfortunately. Eazy-E.
He got fired from everywhere.
Everywhere.
Like.
Everywhere.
Everybody let him go. Because he was trying to fuck on everybody.
Everywhere, T.
You get fired from everywhere. Every piece of pussy. You my fake girlfriend, but what's up, though? You cute.
I'm just saying, so I'm supposed to kiss this bitch and act like I don't like it on camera?
I don't know what you're
supposed to rub. I'm supposed to rub my penis up against.
You're supposed to be a fucking professional.
Up against her body?
Yeah.
And make love scenes and my dick not supposed to get hard?
I'll ask you, the point is, you ain't trying to fuck her though.
You got a love scene with Rihanna, your dick getting hard, bruh? That's sexual harassment.
But I'm not gonna
You're fired. You see what I'm saying?
No, it's not.
No, it's not like that.
No,
your dick can't get hard.
No. First of all, they tape your shit down anyway.
They tape your dick down?
They put fucking...
Hell no.
See, you think people are just out here rubbing a raw dick?
You not taping my dick down.
Vagina.
Who taping my dick down? Is it like a lady that tape your dick down?
I don't know.
Do they use tape that fucking rips the hair, your pubes out? You're not taping my dick down.
You don't, it's a movie stuff, man.
You're not taping my dick down.
You gotta accept.
No.
No, I'm not telling you.
I can control myself. I do this freehand, baby. I got it.
Nah. But the point is, after the scene is over, the scene is over.
It's over with. She's not your girlfriend.
She's not your girl.
Oh, shit.
She owes you no pussy.
She's not your girl.
She owes you no pussy.
I press my hard dick up against you. You my girlfriend.
That's how it works.
That's how it works. That's how you approach it.
Why didn't it?
It didn't work like that at the rink.
Why didn't it?
That nigga showing up at the bitch's trailers and shit.
Fuck is you talking about?
Like so.
So you just gonna get my dick hard like that?
We not gonna finish.
Gonna fuck you tease. Bitch. Fucking bitch.
They like, whoa. Get Jason. Jason,
no,
are you okay?
No, honestly, oh, I knew he was a wild boy when he did the shit at the airport, though.
He's also like 5'3".
Remember he was on the plane and he was wilding out. They wanted him
they
to...
They kicked him off.
Yeah, y'all remember that? This is like right after it. Straight Outta Compton came out.
Well, this nigga's apparently clearly 5'2", though, G. So, like,
he body slammed some chick.
Little niggas act like
they
that.
They be mad.
He was trying to make sex to her. That's all.
Little niggas. So why did he body slam her, though?
Was it a passionate slam?
I don't know. It was enough for her to go to the police. So it wasn't a passionate shit. It was.
She called that
nigga. This nigga is crazy.
She called that nigga little.
Ah, this little
and
nigga.
He,
crazy.
And he lost it.
Little? Body slam. Bitch!
I'm a grown man.
I was beating me. Like, bitch, what are you talking about? I got a show on Showtime. Fuck you. And they took all that
so
shit.
So is it over for the shot?
I don't know. I don't think a lot of people watch it just for his story. So I think they could do something. I don't know. Kill him.
Yeah, nah, it's not no.
Kill him. Do Game of Thrones style. Kill everybody. Kill him.
That'd be dope.
If they just start killing people and making you
just
like
start
other
killing
people.
Killing off characters. Yeah, bringing like how they doing Love and Hip Hop.
Realistic and shit.
Yeah. Kill a character off. Bring in a new character.
Ain't no shorties got killed on the shot yet.
The first two.
Okay. I don't watch the shot.
The first season, it was the first episode a basketball player, high school basketball player get killed.
The chief.
And then like one of the last three episodes, the boy who saw it got killed.
Yeah, okay. Nah, I'm good.
Or, Shorty. I think he saw it, yeah.
Shorty's gotta catch strays out here, man.
I'm good.
They wasn't strays.
It's a shot.
Well, one of them was an accident. The other was you was watching, yeah. The other one was I'm running up on you and shooting you.
Damn. I'm good.
Poor Jason Mitchell, man. Control your dick, fellas.
Yeah, man.
Take it easy.
Learn the lesson from Jay Mitch, man.
Take it easy.
Stop trying to fuck bitches just because they around you, man. You need to.
I don't know. I mean, I don't know. It's kind of confusing, though.
No, it's not confusing. You an actor.
It's kind of confusing. Aisha Curry wants attention. Jason Mitchell is willing to give it to her.
He should have gave her the attention and not the girl.
See how that works?
He couldn't give it to his fake girlfriend on his movies.
That's pretty good. We need to link Aisha Curry and Jason Mitchell up.
Yeah, link them up. She won't want no more attention.
Send Jason Mitchell Aisha Curry song.
She'll be good.
She'll be like, you know what?
You know what?
I changed my mind. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I asked for more male attention. This nigga sending me unsolicited dick pics.
Yeah.
No thanks.
And that's a myth, Joe. I just want to put this out there.
What?
More dick pics are solicited than the stats show, bro. Oh, niggas ain't out here sending their dick out, bro.
Some niggas are. Some niggas don't need any requests.
I'm gonna say yes,
yeah, it's
come on, man. I got a rap for the brothers, man. No, we ain't just out here.
I got female friends, man. Niggas is out
niggas
here
just,
on that.
Man.
Black men don't cheat in 2019. Black men don't send unsolicited dick pics in 2019.
I'm not
man.
Gonna.
Okay,
hashtag
every
that.
Year
I'm not supporting
this,
that hashtag.
They did.
Yeah, bro. I was say
every
until,
year before this.
Up until January 1st, 2019, they was on
they
that.
They was on that every day.
Oh. Sending them.
People change, bro.
Letting them know.
Hopefully bow. They New Year resolution.
Think about your girl.
But you need to take a. We need
to take a break.
Thinking about
that
you.
Damn swisher.
No, that was a funny joke. Thinking about you, girl. We got to take a break.
Then, I don't know. I think we're going to take it.
Are you looking for a legit source of income? Do you bank with Chase, BOA, or any of the credible banking institutions? Then maybe you too can achieve financial freedom. Now, I know you want cars, clothes, hoes, bottles at the club. Baby girl need them bloody shoes. I'm attorney Daquan Davis of Card Crackers. And we have the answers to wiping out debt and building fake credit, as well as additional services. Take control. Who you gonna call? Card Crackers. That's 1-800-FINESSE. That's 1-800-346-6337.
I got to get in tune with Buddy, man. I need a new car.
Exactly. The summertime. Daquan out here.
He's
building fake credit for niggas.
Give me this Bentley truck.
Hey, you know the best part about it? He's a mobile office, man.
Okay.
He'll come to you.
The best part about it is he's a black attorney named Daquan.
Right.
He did a lot to get there.
You know what I mean? The odds were against
him. He filled the bar a couple times just because. They thought he spelled his name wrong. Like, this can't be right. He fills the bar.
They keep denying him and shit. Like, why did he spell the name like
what is this name? He has all the credentials, but this name, Daquan, it's got to be wrong.
That's dude. Everybody want to be a nigga.
You've been saying that for a long time.
Why? Is it cool to be a nigga?
Yeah, we the coolest niggas. That's pretty cool. We the coolest people.
It looks pretty cool. It looks like the glamour life.
Is it fun to be a nigga?
Once you among other niggas.
Depending on your surroundings.
The certain niggas that you want to be around.
I want to know, do y'all know these niggas?
Oh, we got a sleepy man.
Sleepy
man. The sleepy cam. Oh, he's up. He's
up. He's up. He's up. Put your phone down.
You know, just like a woman, you know, start scrolling through his phone.
I wasn't asleep.
I wasn't asleep, man. I was thinking.
Girl, you've been sitting there asleep with your phone in your hand for 35 minutes.
Everybody
want to be a nigga, though, bro.
Yeah.
Y'all know these niggas?
Who?
It was a group. Well, let's. We got the intro, too.
Oh,
yo, okay. You know these niggas?
Yeah, it was Thug Day.
Yeah, it was Thug Day in the high school.
Thug Day.
Thug Day.
For Spirit Week.
Yes, thugs sir. Wear throwbacks.
Yes, right. Sir. That's all thugs wear. It's throwbacks.
And mics.
What team
and
is that, though?
And straight back.
No, go back to that other one, Joe. Go back to that other one. What team is that?
Which one? The two legit?
Yeah, what team is that?
It's the two legit
Mike
to quit
Wade
jersey.
And the two legit
to quit
That's MC Hammer's Summer League?
Yep. Mike played in that. This is 23.
She got the cornrow. Oh, she got the hip hop leggings. Hip hop.
Is that a girl or boy?
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. With the legs.
It doesn't matter. They're thugging, man.
Oh, that's probably a dude.
Yes, sir. She got all the photo ops.
That must be her face.
She must be a thug.
This is where all the pictures came from her page.
With the two legit to quit.
She got the AI braids with the big ass chain.
This is bad. This is
the big hand.
Is she throwing down the forks? What?
Which one? Who?
This bitch, white bitch, right here.
She might. That may be a piece with a.
So are they dropping? They dropping the west side and throwing up the west side.
They got knuckle tats.
Oh, east side, maybe no doubt.
They got face.
She got face
tats.
Yes, sir. Swag. She got a swag tattoo. That's dope.
Okay, well, why didn't they just name this 2004 day?
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, what the fuck is this? All of these people have on throwbacks. This could have just been throwback day.
It was funny. You know who wears throwbacks in 2019? Fucking festival white kids and
festivals.
Shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
that's the title.
I worked at Lolla one year and these kids tried to jump over the fence and shit. They lost They lost like hella shit though. Like all that type of shit. Wicked hats and shit. We definitely took the eBay it. That's crazy though. I don't like that. But I do know that everybody want to be a nigga. We know that though.
White people, man, they are dedicated to
stealing.
To stealing. Did you see the white dude who stole on the two motherfuckers walking down the street?
Yeah, but wasn't that two women?
Yeah, that was two women.
So that was the part that fucked me up. That. I'm like, bro, like, What is you on?
Oh, man.
Dude. He's
super
funny. What?
That nigga held that
it's,
shit.
It's black screen, bro.
And then he walked off and, you know what I'm saying, act like he was...
Did it play? The nigga, it's them Twitter videos. It ain't gonna play.
The nigga walked off. Flexed like he had just did something, though. I was concerned.
You think it's gonna play? Nah, it's not gonna play.
Nah, it ain't.
Okay.
Don't worry about it.
Punk ass nigga. Nobody did nothing. He should have been arrested. That old woman fell out on the floor.
Yo, this nigga just punched somebody's grandma in her stomach. For like, no reason. Hey,
like, and she looked back at him, and then she just died. Like,
They weren't making space for him. He might be from somewhere.
That was my grandma.
But now I do feel him as white men, though, they do. Deal with a lot, man. They places being taken. So at least make space for him in the street, right?
He be fucking street fighter than bitches. Bogus as hell.
Dude was wild.
Man. I wonder if that would have been two black women with the outcome.
Oh, he got his head by now.
Niggas would have been riding around looking for that nigga.
I think they would have got him.
The people would have got him for sure.
The women themselves.
He wouldn't have been able to
do this. And then just keep walking, nigga. Nah. Hey, they'll bust this shit, something. Nigga. Something, nigga.
He might have died that day.
What?
No, not
but that was an elderly woman. So
that was some bullshit. That's some weak ass shit.
So was white dedication and Drake versus the NBA the same thing?
No.
Oh.
But I think he is being dedicated. It is.
What's
dedicated.
Up with that?
I mean, yeah, whatever, man. You know, Drake is Drake, man. What y'all mean?
Drake.
Who was he touching?
He got a plane, bro.
He was touching his team. He was touching his coach.
The coach of the Raptors.
Grabbing his shoulders.
Yeah.
What's wrong with that?
Jack Nicholson, man.
Jack
Nicholson used to be back there with Jerry Buss. Oh.
Jerry Buss is the owner. They kicking it. It's different.
Yeah,
that's not the same.
Yeah, Drake
touching the coach.
What, coaches are untouchable, nigga?
It's just a part of the game that you don't see too often.
But Drake is an innovator. He's bringing new things to the game.
My thing is Drake is the Toronto Raptors now.
Yeah.
It's like Vince Carter, Drake.
They got the fucking like, owls the and shit, Raptors nigga. They got nigga. The they got the OVO training center.
They got the OVO training center. That nigga got a locker.
They out there in the street. You see them talking.
That nigga got a locker.
Drake has a locker.
Yeah,
they
got a
Come
locker.
Come on, man.
I get it. But they was just mad because they lost.
The nigga got the locker. The nigga got multiple OVO jerseys for the Raptors.
Did the NBA say anything about it?
Nah.
No. They haven't made it official. It was just
Mike Budenholzer and shit. He's like, man,
hey, fuck. Hey, man, you just lost, so you care.
He's like, man, that shit was whack.
Bro, he a fan of the game. Like, that's my thing, like, bro.
So wait, like, the Milwaukee coach's daughter wore a Pusher T-shirt.
The Milwaukee owner. Daughter.
Yeah, but see, that's what I'm saying. They wanksters, nigga. We would have flew Pusha T in, nigga. If it was the motherfucking Milwaukee Tux, nigga, we would have flew motherfucking Pusha T in, nigga. He would have performed at halftime, nigga. Infrared, nigga. How much you want to do it? We'll give it to you, bro. That's how. At the game, halftime show, nigga. You're done, nigga.
I don't know why they didn't think to do that.
Fuck out of here, nigga.
The Bucks are pretty good with that shit.
Fuck out of here.
The Bucks ain't flying Pusha T in. Shit.
What? I'm flying Pusha T in, bro.
I am too.
Feel you.
He the president of good music.
And he got Steve Harvey fired, nigga.
Pusha T got Steve Harvey fired?
Mm-hmm. How you make that up?
I read it on the blog.
Whose blog?
Okay.
We'll talk about it after this. We'll take a break.
What?
I'm gonna have an attitude, bitch, I got an attitude. I'm gonna have an attitude, bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude, bitch, I got an attitude. So what, I got an attitude, bitch, I got an attitude. Attitude, 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 attitude. Why?
Okay. It's on IG. Or the Meg.
I don't know. Meg. Yo, we back. We back.
We back with a guest.
We got Mikey Rocks with us, or Sir Michael Rocks.
What you going by?
You can change your name a few times in the game.
I want to be called Randy today.
Randy, we got Randy, Randy in the building.
Randy.
Fucking Rando.
Randy.
A guy named Randy is a real specific kind of guy.
That's a person. That's not
his name. Yeah, Joe.
No.
That's you blessed to be named Randy. You know.
Randy seemed like he an annoying nigga too, though.
I know.
Here come fucking Randy.
But the wickedest.
Yeah, exactly. Here come Randy, bum.
But
ass.
The wickedest thing about Randy is his real name is Randall.
Or Randall.
I'm thinking Randolph. Randolph, you be an ill nigga if your name is Randolph.
If you're not rich, your name is Randolph, though. You probably fucking suck.
Life bad. Life start losing.
Yeah, you gotta be fucking
loaded. You gotta go by Dolph.
Yeah, you gotta be loaded.
By Dolph and do some street shit.
You can fake it, though. Yo, what up, bro?
What's good, man?
I thought they had killed you off, bro. I saw it right on the screen, man.
No. If you watch the credits, they said that he caught a concussion.
Because I'm like, man.
They did the Where Are They Now at the end, but if you stuck around for the credits at the end, like a Marvel movie, you had around and see what the sequel
was. I definitely left, because that shit was long as hell.
It was just a concussion. They didn't show that on screen, though.
So did y'all have to pick who was going to get killed first?
Yeah, we did. And I rock, paper, scissors, and it was me. And it was like, all right, well, we shooting his ass first then.
Okay, good, yeah, good. That sounds like fun stuff, man.
Yeah, it was cool, man. We did that shit about 400 times, man.
Really?
Yeah.
You had to get shot 400 times?
I'm really exaggerating, but it took a long ass. Yeah. We did that shit over and over and over.
What, to get different angles, or y'all was fucking it up?
Chuck kept fucking it up because Chuck wouldn't just fall and hurt himself. He tried to fall off.
He's trying to
safe.
Crumple now.
He keep falling safe. And then they're like, cut. Do it again. You got to fucking fall like you got shot, bro.
He's taking the knee and shit.
Yeah, folks taking the knee and stuff and just laying it down. I'm like, dude, just do it so we can go home, man. Like, it's been 6 hours already. Yeah. Then finally he ran. And actually tripped over his own fucking feet for real. And then the director was like, cut, that's got it. One. We got that's it. That's the one. Got it. He's hurt. Got it. Cool. So that's how that went.
He ain't tell us that.
No, what are you? Never gonna tell you
that. Are you y'all like got some more movies coming out or something?
Whole time caught the niggas in the back rapping. They cold, old job.
Man, it wasn't our fault. They knew who we were gonna be. That shit was a setup.
They had to be professionals or something.
You let Harry Rollins get away with our money.
No, that's not what I'm...
he'd rather hear that shit, but... Dude got his ass smoked too, so it's all good. He got his in the end, you feel me? He ain't get off scot-free.
So do them niggas go... straight English right after they yell cut?
The music.
Because I know they not even from here, so
yeah,
that's...
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. That's how you blow. Like, well, that's all straight.
Look, the whole time we chilling, we'd do our scenes and shit, then you go take a little break while they reset the cameras, do all that shit. He kept his American accent the whole time until the whole day was wrapped. And then he went back straight UK British. Governor, what's up, bruv? Man, I saw you in London, you guys come over to my sport. I love have you over for dinner or supper or something. You guys are good.
That is the wildest shit ever, man.
Yeah, I didn't put two and two together until the end, because he talking to us. I'm like, oh, okay, he must be from Brooklyn or something. He talking like a regular nigga. Then at the end, he get back to the movie, hope, cheerio. I'm like, damn, folks. I'm like, you really is from out there, huh?
You practicing another movie, or what you
doing? Yeah, so then he hit me with that. I'm like, oh, shit, I see the dedication be real, you feel me? Don't break character. Niggas be in character.
I be hearing about that shit all the time.
Niggas be in character, but no, that's a cool nigga, though. I fuck with Daniel a long way, bro.
That's what it is. Man, what you got up? What you got up next? What you been on? Like what?
Yeah. About what?
It's a FX joint, man. It's gonna be on there. I'm feeling like I'm gonna get it. They telling me it's going that way.
Right.
It's a comedy, some little funny shit. About some young niggas, basically. Trying to get some pussy all the time.
Sounds fun, man.
It sounds fun. So hopefully that go well. And then other than that, man, me and Chuck, we damn near finished with a new album.
Okay.
We're getting ready to have that out by like August. I've been working on solo shit, solo music shit.
Yes, I seen you put out like an obscure shit with like a... Yeah.
That was my DJ, the Cool Kids DJ. He DJ for the Cool Kids. His name Owen, man. He make beats too, so we started working on some beats and stuff, and eventually just ended up fucking around making a whole little project. So threw that out like February. But yeah, that's another project and shit. But I'm about to just get ready to drop some more new shit for the summertime. Man, design some clothes. Get some Mariani shit going, man. Get the clothes popping. That's really it. Be streaming, doing the live shit like y'all. We be on the Twitch with it and shit, you know.
What the fuck is Twitch?
That was like some video game shit first, wasn't it?
Yup. It's like just like YouTube Live, really. Same kind of thing.
Right.
But yeah, it's built off like games and shit. Mostly motherfuckers playing shit, and then you know a bunch of people just pull up and watch. But on ours, we do it more like kind of like chill talk show shit. We be DJing on there, fucking around. We'll make music. We'll make some live music and shit right there on the spot with motherfuckers asking you what kind of music you want to hear. What kind of sample you do? Not really. We really trying to. Because they want to grow past that. Okay. Twitch want to grow past that. And we like, all right, we could be the niggas to help y'all do that. So we're trying to like really put our stamp on the other shit besides just the games. Because they got 100,000 niggas playing games on there.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm like,
we could do other shit.
Definitely be getting paid on the Twitch.
They do. It's ugly.
Man, I want to get on Twitch.
What's the boy from what you call it?
Academics.
Oh yeah,
he do that shit.
That's what he do too.
Yeah, that's what he been doing. Yeah, because it's subscribers. It's like you can subscribe to a nigga like you subscribe to Netflix. Monthly fee shit.
You do it anywhere?
No, we got a spot over by my crib. Got a little, you know, a little office and all that, a little studio setup. So we just be doing it over there where we can have fun. The cameras and the audio setup.
So you could do cameras and shit? Like it's like a show. You could do a show on there? That's crazy. Never knew that. I always see his fat ass sitting there playing the game with his shit on.
Right, he just do shit about people. That's just the base model. Okay. But you could have your own layout and shit. Do it however you want to, really. It's pretty crazy.
Really?
That shit pops. It's pretty crazy.
I saw somebody called Jeff Bezos, Bruce Wayne, and Elon Musk was Tony Stark.
Yes, sir.
I thought that was pretty fucking serious.
Yeah, that sounds about accurate, though.
That's about right, damn it.
Fuck around.
They both been crazy.
Fuck around. Bezos, whoop your motherfucking ass and shit.
He damn near is a karate master. Yeah. Bezos, you do karate?
No, I don't really know no karate.
Yeah,
bro.
You do, bro.
I'll fight a nigga.
I seen you in the gi, bro. I seen you, man. That's the karate you
know. It's all cap. Ain't no kicks coming from this way. I got hands, though. I just got good hands. That's all. I got a bob and weave on me, but.
No kicks.
Ain't no kicks.
No kicks.
Okay. I actually was watching this, what was that shit called, man? It's some Israeli self-defense.
Krav Maga.
Dude ass be killing me, bro. He be. It's like a self-defense where if a nigga try to pull something, then you don't really attack him, but you beat his ass to make him chill and get off that bullshit. Like, he'll have you really kick niggas in the nuts and shit. He be like, yup, then you go grab his head, knee his face, kick him in the nuts, elbow him, do all the time.
Oh, like, yeah, I think this way anyway.
He'd like,
kill this nigga.
Yeah, basically, like, get this shit over with as fast as you can. That's the purpose of it, is to get the confrontation over with quick. So he like, you gonna elbow the nigga on the side of his eye, knock that nigga out. You gonna grab his head or something, knee him in the face, kick him in his balls. You trying to get this shit over with quick. You trying to get this shit over with.
That's what the Israeli army practices. Yeah. That's like their hand to hand.
A nigga swing on you, you grabbing his arm and you breaking his shit type shit like that. He just trying to get it over. He not trying to.
Hey man, I don't want
to
hurt you.
Go round and round with you.
But if I have to.
This episode of The Simpsons where Bart Simpson fights a little girl who knows. Cropper guy and shit. Just fucking him up.
Yeah, I was watching that shit the other day on
it's like, I don't know, man. That shit's like a few years ago and shit. Like, but, the Simpsons are in Israel and shit.
Yeah.
You
that's wild. Shit,
I don't even watch The Simpsons anymore. I used to love watching The Simpsons.
Simpsons,
I don't know.
Man.
They lost me, man. I got lost years ago.
I got lost.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I used to fuck with it too, though.
Maybe 10 years ago.
Yeah, no. Nah, I mean, cartoons kind of got like, They'll stay on for a long time, but they still kind of got a little shelf life where you'd be like, all right, I'm kind of over this. Y'all done ran through every storyline. Y'all done gave us
and
every joke.
Cartoons teed up so much harder since The Simpsons.
Yeah.
Like, cartoons fucking and saying pussy and shooting niggas and, making fun of the president and shit. Like, cartoons then exceeded the shock value of The Simpsons at this point.
Definitely.
You know, Simpsons kind of like Rugrats at this point. It's like real tame, safe.
Definitely.
Cartoon
safe
shit.
Safe adult cartoons.
Right. Yeah. Soon as shit like Family Guy, South Park, and all that shit start pulling up.
Get on, the kids gotta go.
Yeah, it's too much. It's too much deeper, you know? So The Simpsons kind of got pushed to like an older crowd, I guess, or more like family crowds and shit, you know? I really be watching the cartoons and shit, so I could put my finger on who they kind of marketing it to. I think The Simpsons at this point more of a like family thing. You know, they still be funny, but more of a like family thing. I remember back in the day, it was the first cartoon really cussing and shit, and then niggas like, this shit crazy.
That shit is mild sauce.
It's mild sauce.
Family Guy
teed up.
Cause like South Park is some shit that's just like ridiculous. But
I mean, American Dad really teed up.
They took it to it.
Like American Dad went crazy with Roger and shit. Roger fucking sexually assaults people. Like,
yeah. I'm gonna tell y'all the hottest show on TV right now, man.
What?
Fucking Red Table Talk. What?
With Jada?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I'll be seeing that.
Come on, bro. Monty.
Smoking that with
you. You watch it?
Yeah.
Y'all
I don't watch Red Table Talk.
Did you tune in?
Why do you watch Red Table Talk?
Man, they talking about pornos and fucking and shit.
You watch that?
I seen it.
Her talk about the porns?
No, that's the newest one, ain't it?
I guess.
She said she was like
a I ain't never watched it, but
she
just
was Kirk
read
Franklin
about it.
At one point.
Damn, she was DJing home fucking parties Kirk and shit at the
Pinkett. Nah, she was fucking, Jada Pinkett was fucking Kirk Franklin.
That's not what I said.
Hell no!
That's not what I said.
Wow!
That's what he said, though.
I said she was Kirk Franklin.
Okay. She was Kirk Franklin.
Addicted
she turned
to
into
porn.
Kirk Franklin?
Addicted to the pornography.
Addicted to porn.
Oh, okay.
Man, you know, sometimes you gotta break stuff down to slow people. It's crazy.
Wait, Kirk Franklin was addicted to porn?
Yeah. What? He was
I mean,
did,
wait a minute. This is like,
this is his thing.
This is like public, not everybody
what?
Like, what?
You know that, Monty, don't you?
I think I heard you tell me that before.
Really, you didn't know that? The room.
I mean, here's the thing.
Nobody
what is addicted
that?
To porn?
I knew that.
Ew. Did you know Kirk Franklin was addicted to porn? Yeah. Did y'all know Tiba? Did you know it?
Yes. Thank Tiba you. Is awake?
Tiba was sleeping.
Tiba was awake.
He just saying yes because you asked him something.
Yes. Yes.
He was
yes.
asking yes. calling his name. Tiba, yes.
No, yes.
I'm just,
yes.
I'm just saying. Wait
somebody
a minute.
Be out here addicted to porn, Joe.
Yes.
What does addicted to porn mean?
I don't
like,
know.
Watch that shit.
Like you walking around
like,
on your phone, jacking off. Like,
enough, I think like,
all free time.
The
Joe.
Definition that I heard of being addicted to porno is when
you hate your wife.
So much porno. Okay. You engage in so much porno that it's affecting other areas of your work and your life. And like you ain't going to work, you late to work.
Yep.
Right.
You fucking off in the bathroom at work because you can't just stop beating it.
Right.
You just gotta keep on cutting that shit.
Then like real sex isn't even like satisfying.
Yeah, you niggas,
that.
Niggas are niggas would be about to have real sex and they'll be like, let me get this phone though.
Right.
Like, shitting me, boy. I'm good on all that shit.
and just watch
this bitch gonna want me to eat her pussy. Right. I'm gonna have to get high. Fuck all this shit.
It sound like niggas is tired to me. I think that's what it is.
Drive trucks.
It sound like niggas is tired.
I'm sleepy.
Facts, but yeah, man. They say
when it starts to affect your home and work life, then you are addicted to pornography.
Definitely right. Too sleepy, Joe.
Right.
Don't want to go do nothing.
Niggas got time for this shit, bro. Like niggas ain't going out no more. You ain't walking the dog and shit.
I'm gonna go out for bro.
You ain't eating right.
Dog shitting everywhere.
Dog in the crib whining and shit.
You ain't eating good. You just
taping. Know what I'm saying?
And buy tapes.
I'm like, she probably had.
Do it, huh?
I'm like,
you could go buy tapes from the sex store.
Yeah, you get tapes.
Yeah, but
I guess early. I hear you though, T. But 11 is.
11. I had porn. I wasn't rich, and I had.
No. I mean, I guess it's cool until you think about your 11-year-old daughter.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
I'm not saying it's cool. I'm just saying but that
it do be happening though. It do be happening. It's just like.
I was just saying I get it. Like
shit, man.
All it takes is that one friend, parents, and they at that sleepover, and he like, y'all want to see something? That's how I seen my first one. Right. I was like, hell yeah, I'm trying to see something.
I saw the nigga came with them
tapes. Boy.
Nowadays, if you 11, I know a shorty probably just to tell you a sight, man. Been to xvideos.com.
Yeah. They got their own phones and iPads.
Nowadays, they know everything.
Bro, it's
nothing.
It's nothing, bro. It's not a thing.
Yeah, no, I agree.
It's nothing at this.
Yeah, but no, yeah, when we were shorties and shit, it was definitely like that one sleepover.
It was a rare sleepover.
It was. I mean, when I sit and think about it.
Got something to show you.
Yeah, it was.
My uncle had hella Playboy magazines and shit like that.
Yes, sir.
Hustler. They was sitting right by the toilet.
Yes, sir.
All in the little rack. Like, I'm like, oh, I'm watching TVs.
No, I found the Playboys under my uncle's bed in my grandma's crib.
They was in my uncle's garage.
Oh,
a big ass box. It was endless, nigga. I mean, that box was. It had to have reached the roof, bro. Like, we was in there like for 6 hours. Like,
damn,
like,
G.
The first naked woman I saw was that I remember was Vanessa Williams in the penthouse.
Oh, that was fire, though.
Miss America. So she set the blueprint for my taste. Thank you, Vanessa.
Yeah, she might have
ruined it. I don't know
the person. Fucked
yeah, it. Yeah, I know, right? She did.
Yeah, she messed you up.
She did, right? Because
nobody really comes close.
Nah.
When you go back to reality.
When the first time
I ever seen somebody shoot a basketball was Michael Jordan. Changed my life.
Oh wait, look, we got the Jada video, Joe. Can we?
He just played it.
Oh, he played it again.
He played it already.
Oh shit! I didn't know it was playing. Damn, Jada, you breaking my heart, man.
Well, she's good.
I've been fucking with Jada more and more, actually, as she's gotten older. I'm like, okay, Jada, I see you.
Yeah,
like, Jada back.
I don't know, she likes the new Jada's face.
I mean...
Hey, man. Look.
What, she got work done or something?
Come on, guys. Y'all
got to take
what
you
can
get.
I don't think she got work done. Black don't crack.
Let me say that
honestly. Jada look good. Look at that. If I was my fucking 45, 50, then Will just turned 50.
Yeah, something like that.
If I was 50, you know, I was 50, then what?
Look good, though.
Nah, man, she got some work done. Y'all clear that.
Hey.
She got some work done, man.
I'm not saying she did. I'm not saying she did if she didn't. I'm saying she looks good. Because now, in 2019, I don't even know if getting work done is a disqualifier for
something. I don't want to abide by those rules.
Let me see that light.
Sorry to tell
you. Money, those rules
suck. The world has changed, Larry.
So work done. This
doesn't matter no more? No.
No.
Doesn't matter anymore?
Doesn't matter anymore.
No.
Nah, yeah, that's
after
the level of work matters, but no. Just the general, like, she has.
I mean, not in my book, but for the world standard now.
Who was bad who didn't have work?
Who's bad who didn't have work?
Who the baddest woman that didn't have work done that we know that didn't have, well, I mean, that we think didn't have work done? Because we don't know.
Right,
shit.
We kind of, it's hard to tell.
You gonna say Sade? You know what I'm saying? You don't know. Like,
I don't know.
Yeah, the work could be so subtle.
That's I'm tough. Trying to, you got, we'll
think
come
about
back.
It. No, I don't really
we'll come back
about
to
it.
That.
Yeah.
Nia Long? You fuck with
Nia Long?
Nia Long?
Did she get it? She ain't get none?
I don't think she got none, but I don't know.
I don't know.
Nia Long.
But she's a good, I don't know.
She's still cute, yeah.
Here we go.
My prototype for a long time.
Here we go, because we going with like younger, right?
Yeah.
We got Nia Long, Ashanti, and Maya.
Oh, Maya's killing all them, bro. I ain't gonna lie, bro.
Those are the only ones that I don't think had no work done that still look decent.
Ashanti had a little bit.
Somebody told me Ashanti had
a little
bit. No.
I mean, I don't even see her enough, though.
She's still pretty young, too, though.
Yeah, like,
you mean, like, has been around? Like,
yeah, I'm saying it's like over Maya, 40.
Maya age okay. Them,
yeah.
Like
40 and up.
Yeah, she killing everybody.
Maya, Maya is the best.
She just hit 40.
She be drinking water and shit, man.
Yeah, you know, since y'all vegan and shit. Talking about she smell death on people's breath.
What is it?
Oh wow!
Yoga, hot yoga.
I actually got pissed off when I read that Maya. You know, she's like, I wouldn't date a guy who ate meat because I would smell death on his breath.
Pause.
I was like, bitch, how dare you? How dare you disqualify me like that?
Right. Disqualified off the bat.
Right.
Checked you off the box list.
Yeah, like, how dare you crush my dreams in this manner?
So you eat meat?
Right.
Like, get your murdering ass out my face.
Next, like on the bus.
It's gonna be a lot of lying niggas like, no, I ain't eating 3 years. Shit
coming out his pores and shit.
She pop up at the crib on your ass and you
I
got
smell
Italian
the ribs
beef.
On your
she
elbows, nigga.
Like, nah, I can tell by your body.
You got Italian beef with sweet peppers at the crib. She pop up on you as a surprise.
Surprise! Wait.
She delivered it. She delivered it. I know Alex from
Uber Eats. Wait a minute, yo.
Y'all ain't no vegans? Y'all ain't no vegetarians?
Never tried that.
I think mine is.
Are you?
No, I nigga, I came in here with arrows. I came in here with the pack, boy. Yes, it ain't no.
I was like, no.
There's no hope for me. I can't go, man. I tried to be a vegetarian for about a month. Nigga, I started getting headaches and being dizzy and shit. I was all weak. I felt like a nigga. I felt like a nigga could whoop my ass, bro. I'm like, I'm weak and tired as hell, G. I don't like this vegetarian.
I feel
shit.
Like vegetarian waking up and vegan headaches. Shit is something for white people and stuff.
Fact.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, I mean, I grew up like.
Cause they got the thinner lips.
I grew up with family, like
they
really close family members who
they can't taste. Yeah, they can't taste.
They can't taste the real
flavorful meats.
They tongue can't taste because they lips is skinny. Yeah.
So I grew up
crazy.
With like close family members who have who became vegetarians because they had like history of colon cancer in their family and shit.
Did they stop it?
No. So like no, like yes and no, but that's just, you know,
right. That's a whole nother story, right?
But so I grew up with people around me who were vegetarians, and so I just never like really got into it, and shit. So there is a way you can do it. If you really wanted to be a vegetarian or a vegan, it's the way you could do it, and you'd be,
still
you know,
have your weight and still have your
you'd be good.
You just gotta,
you gotta know what you're doing.
Yeah, you can't have a job.
Keep a chubby ass a motherfucking vegetarian.
Yeah, that's why you sleep.
Right.
Yeah, because you're tired.
Man, that's tired. How I was.
He don't look like he's hurting, bro. He look like he missing no meals.
I'm just like, no, I'm not the tight end. I'm on the vegetables,
G.
I got it.
That nigga T ain't missing no meals. Look at that belly sticking out from the bottom of that T-shirt.
Definitely
healthy.
It's beers. No, yo, we gotta do rap pants. You fuck with rap pants?
Yeah,
you got rap pants.
I got a bunch of them.
You said different stylings.
What's your favorite rap pants you ever seen? Like, who's your favorite rapper?
Lupe.
Lupe?
Okay.
That nigga.
Damn.
He got those.
Hey, Pay. Okay. Okay, damn. We gotta check. I gotta check Lupe.
He got them pocket hands.
Interesting.
I don't know who we got.
Luke Method was cold too. Method Man had that.
Facing upstage, put up your left jazz hand, then your right jazz hand, and then wave them. And up. Up. Again. Pivot to face the front. And country heel drags. And left. And right. Now Latin style. Stop. Four times. Here comes your jazz hands. Left. Right. Clap first. Here's your hands. Now up left.
Bro.
No, I hit the wood though. I ain't had no swisher in a minute, man. That don't hurt your throat?
Nah.
He developed that airport landing strip.
Yeah, he been doing it so long, he addicted to it.
Man, it's really, I think y'all addicted to the trash, bro.
What you
know, it just really hurt my...
Wood.
I,
You smoke wood when you smoke?
Or I smoke rosewood.
Okay. How many blunts you get out of a pack of wood? How many blunts you get out of a pack of wood?
That work, actually? Yeah. Probably one. And the rest of them be damn near stale. And
this is what I'm saying, like, this is the life. Hard,
man. I mean, I didn't say it wasn't an expensive lifestyle, but you know what I'm saying?
Tough life,
it's one that I dedicated myself to, so.
It's tough life.
Yeah, that's what I tried to tell them, man.
I didn't say it was logical.
You're not going back to sweets. You're either going to go to papers, you're going to get these leaves.
Yes, sir. Come on, big boys.
I don't even buy these.
Came with the owls. That's,
big boys.
That's how you feel?
Even these big are expensive
boys.
To
with
me.
With the owls.
You know, come on, bro.
How much them is?
These what's like up? Two something, 250, I think.
Yo, did you fuck with the Spice Girls?
I liked the black one.
Ah, Mosley, funny.
She was scary when I was.
Scary Spice.
Of course, the black one got
the black one had to be scary.
Scary Spice.
No, I fucked with her. She was cute to me back in the day.
Stay well.
Yeah, that's Eddie Murphy ex wife, man.
Stay well. Damn near. Yep.
Mama too, I think.
Yeah, definitely knocked her down. Ed.
Ed.
Yup, no, they was cool. My sister used to fuck with them, and then I seen the black one. I'm like, she's kind of with it.
Yeah. She got herpes in the eye, bro. Yeah.
Herpes in the eye.
Herpes strikes again.
Lying. How the fuck do you?
She came out with a straight.
The herpes strikes again.
Herpes in the eye.
Hey man, in the eye. Herpes in the eye.
Wildlife, man.
Been doing a lot of things.
Been living the interesting life.
That was what I like. That's what the report said.
Give me that one more.
So it's not confirmed.
See that.
She said she did.
Oh, so she denying it. Maybe somebody just trying to fuck her.
Yeah,
Eddie Murphy on some trash.
Again, I mean, that's a hell of a random, specific ass slander.
Yeah, and herpes in the eye. Herpes
in the eye.
I wonder how.
And then you got to come out and then debunk it. Like, nah, I ain't got herpes in the eye. I got octomachotonomous in the eye. Some other shit like, yeah, whatever, bitch.
That's another word.
Right, like you got herpes.
Yeah, that's the one.
That's all niggas need
Latin
to
hear. Word. Like,
well, I don't care about all the other shit you said. You said you got herpes or something?
You got something in your eye, huh?
You got herpes. Something in your eye?
Exactly.
Every time he talks to me, they just staring at you in that one eye and shit. Like,
motherfuckers backing up and shit. Niggas don't want to use the. Niggas don't want to use the. Niggas ain't trying to use the binoculars after you and shit.
I don't want to look at you.
Motherfuckers like, no, you can't use my camera, shorty. You gotta use your own camera.
Can't get my glasses.
Use my camcorder? No, not today.
My glasses down. Don't even touch the glasses up here.
Niggas ain't got the binoculars.
No, she can't do shit. She can't wipe her eyes and nothing.
See, nigga, this is what I'm saying.
Wipe your eye. You gotta go.
You gotta
pee.
This
you
brings
hold
me,
your hands up. And I'm
opening
up.
I'm saying this brings me to a bigger issue, man. It's cleanliness, man. Motherfuckers not clean.
I don't
clean
think that's
no
how you
more,
transfer
bro.
Herpes, but.
It is, man.
It is, though.
You wash your fucking ass, man.
I don't think transferring herpes had anything to
wash
your.
Yeah, man. No. Herpes started. From, as we said, a jealous husband, niggas.
Right.
Bitch cheated on. He was a scientist. Thomas J. Herpes, yeah. Scientist.
This is
scientist. Bitch cheated on him. Right. He caught her. Mm-hmm. He developed some serum, you know what I'm saying, to give himself herpes. Fucked her. Bow. Popped her off. She got it. She go back. Fuck dude. Bow. He was a player. He fucked a whole bunch of other bitches.
Damn, he just, you know what I'm saying?
Bow, there you go. Herpes.
I'm saying herpes.
I forgot what point I was going to make before I said
but,
this.
But yeah, but you were trying to make the point that it had to do with transferring and cleanliness.
If you, niggas be, because niggas don't be washing their dick after they get it. Fuck, man. That's what it is, bro. Bitches don't be washing their motherfuckers.
So if you wash your dick after you have sex, you won't get herpes.
Yes. Facts,
okay.
Bro.
Okay. All right.
Facts, all right. Bro.
Hot take.
All right.
Facts, bro. Look that shit up. I saw it on Wikipedia.
You should definitely piss after you have sex, though. You got to
Yeah, get all of that shit up out of you, bro. But nah, niggas don't do shit. They go and start smoking woods with their guys. Start smoking woods with their guys.
Got that hurt marinating on their dick.
Hands grabbing everything.
Exactly.
Don't wash their
hands. Exactly,
no
bro.
Hand sanitizer.
You pass the blunt to your man.
That's why you should smoke swishes, bro.
Definitely have hand sanitizer.
But no, look, motherfuckers not eight. Okay. Show the way. It's a clip, Joe.
Okay, how many of you guys took a shower this morning? Less than eight.
Beginning, though. Okay, it's gone.
It's blacked out.
I'm sure you all think you washed your bodies correctly, but many of you are wrong. In fact, you may have been washing the wrong way your entire lives. Not to fear, we are here to set you straight in a new segment we call
The Mirror. It's supposed to be the middle where they're talking about motherfuckers not washing.
You've been doing it all wrong!
Yeah, that's crazy.
The white people don't need these fucking washcloths. Dermatologist Dr. Janine Downey.
White people don't need these washcloths.
Man, my white homies, bro, like, sometimes you spend the night at their crib, it ain't no washcloth, for one.
See?
And then,
see?
After the shower, you about, where the towel's at? Like, oh, it's one right in there. I'm like, who the fuck towel is that? Like,
it's just a general house towel?
Yeah, it's just general towel.
Hell no!
You got me fucked up, dude. Like,
see?
I went and got the washcloth and get the pad myself out with that. I'm like, bro, we can't go.
That's how herpes is passed, bro.
You got the next question.
And I was confused because I was like, bro, this is my first time like having the white sleepover. Like, yeah, I don't know what's going on. And they're like, this is the towel right here. It's already wet. I'm like, it's already a little damp. Like, somebody right, like, did something with this? Like, what we got to do? Like,
airs in that motherfucking type shit.
That's weird, man. And I don't know what it is, but yeah, man, sometimes it be happening like that.
But on the flip side, sometimes niggas use too many washcloths. I swear, I used to have a roommate. I swear, they used to have like 3 washcloths sometimes. Yes, so I'm like, bro, what
is
the third one
face.
For?
My face and my ass.
One for my ass.
One.
Why do y'all need my body?
But why do you need a towel for your face?
Face, ass, and body, bro.
I'm talking about a washcloth.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Oh,
why you need a washcloth for
to
your
dry,
face?
To dry the soap and shit off your face. With your wipe it off with a hot towel, bro. Come on, bro.
Okay. All right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Face, body, and ass, man.
The three washcloths.
The Holy Trinity.
Yeah, I'm about to say, that's a lot of washcloths.
She said that they was using what, loofahs?
No, yeah, which is fucking disgusting.
Loofahs.
Yeah, I don't even know what the fuck that's about.
Not something.
But no, I wanted to show the part when the bitch was saying she don't wash her feet, man.
They said they don't wash their bottom.
They let the soap run down. In the shower.
It's just like your feet are standing in soapy water. So like,
soap doesn't just.
Yeah, you need some kind of pressure and friction applied.
You gotta make that shit happen. Exactly. You can't just
look at that shit.
Do you scrub your feet with soap?
But the doctor called them out and say y'all lying. The doctor say y'all lying. I know y'all nasty motherfuckers don't. 64, y'all don't wash y'all feet, man. Khloe Kardashian, didn't she put up something saying she don't wash her fucking...
She don't shower every day. It's like twice a week or three.
Yeah, she said some other goofy shit too, man. She said,
what the fuck is with this?
She said something about,
well,
like...
Well, what I know is black women don't do this stuff.
Right, well,
this is what I do know. Black women shower.
Niggas shower like a motherfucker. Niggas might take 2 showers.
Yeah, they
might
take 2
showers a day.
Niggas might be in the shower for 35, 40 minutes. Yeah.
I'll be that nigga. I'll be there for an hour and shit, man.
Hell yeah.
I'll wash up, then I'll stand there. And that bitch would be standing there.
Nigga, I was just standing in the shower earlier.
Get some deep thoughts off.
Yeah, get all your day thoughts off.
We got a window in our shower and shit. I'd just be standing there staring out the window like, oh, man.
Just look at
what I'm going to do today, man.
Don't know Carl Thomas come on your dark day.
I don't even be having no music on. I just really be in deep thought, like, man, you know what I'm saying?
What is this unmarked?
That's weed lane, bro.
This is unmarked package.
Marilyn.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Pull up.
Yep. So, pull up.
Get your Sprite or something.
Pineapple Fanta.
Cannoline.
What a god.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
And it's like weed, THC.
I want to pull some up. I've been telling them I want to pull some up.
Why y'all ain't putting
no
up?
He's scared.
Y'all got it here.
I'm with it.
I'm like, y'all.
Let's fuck our days up real quick. Come on, we need a pop.
Y'all ain't got no pop.
To
go get one.
Let's ruin our night real quick.
Yeah, drink I can ruin my day. I ain't got too much to do.
Come on.
I'm with the shit.
Man, y'all ain't with the shit.
That shit look like
no pop. Smoothie going up.
It look a little.
I'm actually pulled.
It's a house of health, man. You know what I'm saying? They don't really have stuff like that.
They don't have sodas and shots.
They got LaCroix in there.
Y'all remember the white kid in Canada who's making the money off of all the rappers and shit?
Did they take his ass to jail?
Hell no.
What are you
doing? That nigga's killing the game.
He's selling like rappers fucking the Canadian flavors of Crush. Crush makes a clear cream soda in Canada that they don't sell in the States.
Oh, yeah.
Lamar sell cases of that shit on the internet. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He's tracking that shit in Detroit.
He got in trouble?
He got caught once, but he just had to like pay a fine. And then he fucking, he just been doing it again ever since. He just switched up the way he does it. He just pays hella shipping, you know what I'm saying?
Wait.
He pay like, they say he cost him like, maybe like $7 for a 24 pack all said and done, like $8. He sells some bitches for like $50, $60 or something shit like that.
What?
Each 12 pack.
What?
Niggas got a sip, bro. Like my guys that's really hooked on that shit, bro. They will pay anything, especially for a rare flavor pop or some goofy shit, boy. Right. They'll pay that ticket, man. They'll do
he
it.
He said the motherfuckers want that clear shit.
Why do you need a rare flavor pop? Or like, what is the allure of it? Is it?
I guess it's just like, cause it can't taste that different. Goddamn it, I don't know. Yeah. Like. Maybe it's just they want to, niggas, you know niggas want to be cool and have some shit, okay. Niggas ain't
yeah, got
like
the clear one. Might be like,
the clear one, they
like
said,
it is what it is, really.
They like the green.
It's like niggas that only smoke Russian cream, backwoods and shit.
Exactly. Right.
You driving an hour up north to some random suburb and shit.
I know a spot that got some for $7 too.
Niggas would definitely drive an hour there, an hour back to
what?
Go get some
niggas
Russian cream.
Going far for Russian cream. That's a thing, for sure.
Niggas come back
niggas
with that
love
box
Russian
too.
Cream. It's a whole song about it on
Yo.
Key Glock
album. Yo, niggas do love Russian cream. This motherfucker, man, did you just hear this motherfucker?
Nigga snort himself.
Snorkel. The fuck, man, wake up.
We gotta get T with the bed, man.
I guess we gotta go, man. I guess that must mean it's time to.
He done had enough,
man.
Hey, you got anything coming up soon?
Man, we gonna be at Division Fest out here. We performing up there.
Okay.
That's damn near next week, I think.
Damn, all right.
We're gonna be performing at the Lyrical Lemonade Fest 2 on the 29th of June.
Okay.
I forgot where that shit's supposed to be, but it's somewhere around here. And yeah, we're gonna be doing some shit at Lala too in August. Right. So yeah, niggas around this summer, we'll be out here.
Okay.
We need that.
Okay.
You know?
New music coming for August too.
The people
all that
been
shit.
Waiting on y'all for a long time, man. Y'all started all of this shit for real.
Oh yeah, oh
so.
Yeah.
Yeah, before we get out of there, how you feel about that?
How do you feel about that?
It's
Do people big bro you? They be like, big bro.
Big niggas that be older than me a big bro me, and
yeah,
I'd be
sure.
Like, bro, what do you mean? Like,
I know some people do that to me.
I think it's just like a mental thing, damn near. Like when somebody finna ask you for something, they be like, let me
the
big
shit
bro.
They trying to do like, oh man, I remember when I was in high school, bro. Yeah. You was that nigga, bro.
Yeah, no, it's weird because it's like, you know, you never really can see shit happening as it's happening, you know? I didn't know we was, you know,
right.
Kick off a bunch of shit like that, you know what I mean? We was just doing what we did. And it's cool to see the, you know, it's cool to see the effect and the influence of shit. But I got a lot more shit that I really want to do, man. I got a lot more shit that I really want to do too, so I don't like to get too stuck in that or
what you did.
Get too stuck in what you did and try to rest on that. Cause we accomplished a lot of cool shit, you feel me? And niggas definitely could be like, well, I did this, so bam. You know what I'm saying? I'm still, niggas gotta do this for me, woo woo. But I choose to just keep on trying to do some new shit, man. That's always how I've been, bro. So, you know, I just wanna keep on reinventing my own wheel, really, and make the shit fun for myself. Cause if it ain't fun for me, then I can't make it fun for nobody else.
That's what's up, man.
Yeah.
Shit. I guess we could wrap it up
on
that.
Yeah.
Hey, that's real.
Man, thanks, bro.
I appreciate y'all having me, man. You already know what it is. Anytime, man.
Yes, sir.
Niggas been down since motherfucking.
Yo, you remember the dust?
Stone Age, nigga.
Man, you came through, man.
Nigga, we was down in the basement. What was we at, man?
At Pillar. Shout out to Jay Pillar.
Jay Pillar, what's the deal?
Ground Zero Studios, yeah, man.
Hell yeah, we was down there.
I was almost
cooking up.
What, 6, 7, almost 10 years?
Nigga, almost
10 years. No, that was
10
years ago.
Yeah,
probably
10 years ago, something, bro.
Thanks again, man.
Like 20 years ago.
Back, bro, since damn Yates and shit, man. Niggas go back, man. That's what they don't know.